You're in trouble, Brainiacs. While just moments ago you were heading for a long, comfortable stay at an all-inclusive resort in the tropics, now you find yourself bobbing in the waves near a small, potentially hostile desert island armed with nothing more than what you're wearing. From tropical thunderstorms to poisonous food to feral animals, desert islands aren't exactly the most hospitable environments. But don't worry. Armed with the right information and a positive outlook, you can survive. Before we get into exactly what you'll need to stay afloat, make sure you like and subscribe to the Brainiac YouTube channel. We're not going to sugarcoat it for you, Brainiacs. The next couple of hours will be pretty rough. It's likely that whatever transport method you were taking prior to the shipwreck, boat, plane, submarine, came to an abrupt and violent stop before you disembarked. If that's the case, you're probably dealing with some kind of injury. Hopefully it's nothing too serious. After assessing your injuries, you'll need to wade onto land, navigating dangerous terrain covered with sharp coral and pointy rocks, while taking care not to get cut. After all, we're in the tropics now, and even the smallest cut can get infected and gangrenous. And while you may be the only human on the island, that doesn't mean you're alone. In fact, your new roommates likely include poisonous insects, snakes, and dangerous wild animals. Oh, and don't think that just because you're on a tropical island, the weather will be all peachy. Tropical islands are particularly prone to thunderstorms that will drench you in a bone-chilling water spray and may give you hypothermia if unprepared. So, now you know the challenges that await. How can you take them on and come out on top? Step number one is to look for other survivors. For the purposes of this video, we're gonna assume that you traveled alone. But if you do happen to be with other people, make sure you locate them and band together. There's strength in numbers. Working together will increase your odds of survival and alleviate the mental effects of isolation. After all, a problem shared is a problem halved. If you can't find any other survivors, draw a face on a volleyball and call it Wilson. That might help you out. Next, you'll want to salvage the wreckage of whatever transport you are in, prioritizing useful items like knives, hammers, and axes. Be creative when doing this as well. Lots of items can be repurposed for other uses. Assuming you've gathered all the supplies you'll think you'll need and you've safely made it onto dry land, your number one priority should be to locate drinking water. Now you may be thinking, hey, wait a second, there's water all around me. And you'd be correct. Unfortunately, it's likely salt water, meaning it's not drinkable. In fact, it will only serve to dehydrate you further. Instead, look for streams and rivers with fresh water and make sure you boil before drinking to get rid of any harmful bacteria or parasites. To help locate fresh water, keep an eye out for plants. Like humans, plants also need water to survive. So if you see one, it's usually a good indication that a water source is nearby. Once you've secured a water source, your next thought should be of shelter. As we mentioned earlier, desert islands tend to be frequently targeted by thunderstorms. A shelter made from branches and leaves, or materials scavenged from the wreckage of your ship, will protect you from the elements and give you a place to rest and brainstorm your next move. Now that you've got a place to relax, you'll want to get a fire started. Fires can be used to boil your drinking water, ward off animals, even serve as a signal to potential rescuers. While the odds that you've got your hands on a functioning lighter are quite low, starting a fire is fairly easy if you know how. By aggressively rubbing a hardwood stick onto a softwood stick, you can create enough friction to set light to the tinder. Building a fire is an essential part of any survival kit, so if you don't know how, make sure you learn as soon as possible. While a fire can serve as a rescue signal, spelling out an SOS signal using rocks or sand doesn't hurt either. Now that we've got some more pressing issues out of the way and set the stage for a potential rescue, you'll want to find food to keep your energy levels high. Despite what you might think about a desert island, there should be plenty of food around. Islands tend to be surrounded by mollusks, oysters, clams, mussels, seaweed, fish, and plenty more. You can also look for fruits and edible plants on the island itself. Careful though, a lot of unfamiliar foliage can actually be poisonous. If you want to know if something is safe to eat, try the following procedure. Rub it on your hand and wait to see if there's a reaction. If nothing happens, rub it on your lips. If nothing happens again, hold it in your mouth, and then if nothing happens, go ahead and eat it. Now be warned, this method isn't completely foolproof, but you'll have to be really unlucky to eat a dangerously poisonous fruit this way. If and only if everything else on this list has failed, you should look into building a raft. This is a last resort, though, as raft sailing is dangerous and you don't want to find yourself capsizing over an ocean's wave. Now, if you follow this survival guide to the letter, you should find yourself in a relatively promising position. With nothing but your wits and whatever you could scavenge from around, you've got food and water, built up a nice little shelter, and set up signals to help facilitate your own rescue. Time to sit back, crack open a coconut, and watch the sunset while waiting for the cavalry to come, which should be any day now, right?